He took the rejection well.
My God!
Oh, man. Good luck.
So how are you today? Cats are so freaking weird, man. He like totally came over and was like, hey, what's up? Hi, love me. And then I pick him up and he's like, how dare you? Hi, you dolls. Welcome back. And if you were new, hello, my name is Jesse. And today we are going to react to season 4, episode 7 of Never Have I Ever Had an Identity Crisis. What is going on in this one? As Paxton struggles to let go of his past as the king of high school, he seizes a chance to thrive as a swim coach and finds closure with an old flame. Interesting. Sammy here, my nose. I love anything centered around Paxton. I think it's always fun to see him and watch him grow even more so than he already has. Let's just jump in, but before we do, don't forget to throw a like, but it's like if you do not like what you see, but comment down below, let me know why, subscribe if you haven't yet, we do fun. Thanks for ringing the bell to be notified when I upload new videos, and don't forget to check the link down in the description for my Patreon. It is $5 a month, it's only $1.25 a week, and has all of my unedited reactions of everything that I do on YouTube. In addition, more, don't forget to follow us on all social media, @star_chef_productions, or @jizzydobby for Twitter. I've had to do that a total of 7 times today. My tongue has gotten a workout. It almost sounds like upload new videos is upload nude videos. So if anybody's making that mistake, I swear that's not what it says. It's definitely upload new videos. Without further ado, this is season 4, episode 7 of Never Have I Ever Had an Identity Crisis.
Well, hello there, crickets. It's time once again to take a ride in the coolest shit brain of Paxton Hall Yoshida.
Yeah!
He was still
I love when
jungle.
They do these kinds of episodes.
Things have been going great. He was invited to every rager, kegger, and kickback. All he had to do was coach a little swimming and show up to a few mandatory staff meetings.
Feels like the students help me more than I help them.
That has overwhelmingly been the case.
Overwhelmingly been the case.
Awesome.
Thank you, Paxton. His current life wasn't exactly what he'd planned for himself.
Aww. Cuisines of the world, faculty potluck is coming up. Luxembourg, oh, the hell did they eat that?
Tips on bringing the bonus loop. Paxton, could I interest you in going in on a dish together? The pot is very heavy.
Sorry, Mr. Shapiro, not gonna make it.
There's this crazy coincidence where his schedule conflicts with every single faculty social event.
What a coinkydink.
First faculty member to be voted prom king.
Okay, I see the issue that Lindsay had now. He is trying to live in the past. He is not trying to live in the present.
Doesn't matter how pretty you are, so some of you can stop flexing.
Oh, yeah.
Eric Perkins had tried out for the swim team every year. He took the rejection well.
My God!
Oh, man. Good luck.
I admire him trying, but like, Eric, maybe learn how to swim
back
and then
up, back up.
Better luck next year.
Man, sorry, didn't work out.
Come on, Pax, hit him with some of that effortless charm.
The local
swimming
municipal pool.
Life.
I don't want to swim with some run-of-the-mill dill holes. I want to swim as a cricket. You want to train me? Oh my God, yes.
What?
Wow. How about one night with my girlfriend Rosalia? She's brought it up independently, so I think she'd be down. I don't want everyone to think of me as a failure.
And here was the one way Paxton and Eric were the same.
I know I belong there, just like how you realized you belonged back at your old high school.
Ow, why did that sting?
Oh, no girls allowed.
Dude, you are fully clothed.
I say we get high, order some soup dumplings, and then transport ourselves into the loins of the Matrix.
Yeah, I'm game.
Excited to become one of Paxton's little swimmers. Hope you boys didn't wear him out too much.
Should be interesting.
Go!
I need a dude. You can breathe under there?
No, dude, obviously not. When your face is in the water, you exhale. And when you come up...
It's better.
Oh my God! Inhale!
Oh, Eric.
I thought you'd be cool with me telling a couple people. But you know, we can go somewhere else if it's like a thing.
Nah, it's totally cool.
But it didn't feel cool. His little get-together had swelled into a huge rager.
Is he gonna go back to college?
Paxton, how could you throw a party and not tell me?
Oh, that was sick.
He's over that.
You brought
He's
a cake.
I don't know, but this is like the biggest party of the year. Do you want me to get rid of everyone? I know how to clear a room. I can totally whip up a classic Dave meltdown just that. Like that.
I just feel sexy right now, you know what I mean?
You know what, no. I think I probably just need to relax.
Uh-oh, is it gonna be Lindsay?
Paxton?
Yep. Lindsay, hey.
A drunk kid called the student hotline.
One shot of apple juice.
Hi, Miss Thompson. You're having a party with all these students?
Okay, it's actually a funny story. I got an Oculus recently, and damn.
Oh.
This looks really bad. I mean, it is really bad. That's why it looks really bad.
Oh, no, thank you, and then close the door.
It's not that simple.
No, it is that simple. I mean, you're a staff member and they're students. Grown up to grown up? What are you doing? Get your shit together, dude.
Yeah.
I was reading Michael Phelps' biography, and he had a bit of a head start on me. So we're gonna have to bump up our training sessions to like 3.
Why not just give up?
Why would I give up? We barely started.
Because it's going to be a super hard uphill climb.
What kind of person just gives up on their dream when they haven't even tried?
Yeah, Paxton. Who would do that? You know anyone?
Let's make you a jock.
Nice look!
Oh!
How was that?
We can do better.
Who was that for?
We can do better. Come on, do it again.
Did I make you proud of me?
Yes. Trust it. Whoa, okay. Noodle.
Oh, noodle.
If I could move my shoulders right now, I'd hug you.
No problem, man. I'll set it up.
Ow.
I lost a lot of money to the janitor, Stacy.
Wait, you bet against me?
The odds were not in your favor.
That's definitely true. Feeling kind of hopeful.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no.
Hey, it's all right. We can call someone. Although my phone is out by the pool, he'll definitely come looking for me.
What if Akshara from Princeton called me back?
I do know about getting too many calls from thirsty girls, and you're not coming off well.
How dare you? Can I ask what really happened at ASU? Being hot all your life actually turned out to be a disadvantage?
Yeah, I guess so. Did you say sexually successful? No, no, hold up.
Oh, actually, first Ben was. First.
Ben? Close? What?
She bangs.
Damn. Mm-hmm. Okay.
I really thought it was gonna be you.
Why? Because you came up to me out of nowhere. Did.
You told me that we couldn't be together until I liked myself.
Damn. I said that.
You weren't wrong.
It's pretty honest.
I was kind of a maniac.
Maybe a little bit.
Are they gonna kiss?
You're way too good for me.
Shut up.
Oh God! Oh God! Yeah, he's an employee
I know
now.
You used to be a student here less than a year ago.
Yeah,
I know
Davey
faculty. Used to be your girlfriend. This is your one warning.
Oh my God! It's so weird. Like I don't think of him like a teacher, but he is. He's on the faculty. He can't do that.
It's your turn to say grace. So Dad's tuning his guitar in case you need musical accompaniment.
Okay. I'm a.
Whoa,
oh,
honey.
Paxton.
Why would you say something like that? You're too young to be a failure. Uncle Gary, he's a failure. He's 55 and he's in prison for defrauding a children's hospital.
Oh my God.
Tried to do something.
Let go of who you were and find out who you want to be.
His
One
parents are the
chorus
best.
Our God is an awesome God, and a full night's sleep later, Paxton was back at school.
Got it, Eric. Let's go. I'm rooting for you, bud. We got this arc. Nice entry. Nice turnaround.
Good
job, Eric.
So, how'd I do?
JV alternate.
Yes! Go, Eric!
All right. So proud of you.
That's
Dude,
awesome.
That was very moving.
I actually changed someone's life today.
Yeah.
Like, I helped them.
What
a
great teacher you are.
So, I assume we probably can't do that again.
Not if I want to stay employed.
You definitely still know what you're doing. Did feel like closure.
Yeah. It did.
It did.
Oh, David. Isn't it cultural appropriation to dress up like a pinata?
Oh, yeah. Sick necklace, Tiny Soprano.
They're still alive and well.
What? Oh, no, there are no.
None of my professional business.
He was ready to retire that crown in search of something else.
Yo, Paxton!
I'm not gonna be able to make it.
He wasn't quite sure exactly where his path was gonna take him, but he knew he was at least moving forward.
Oh, so, he showed
Pax,
up.
What are you doing here?
Watching Tyre.
Oh.
Student help hotline? I'm down.
Oh. Dude. He's the popular teacher.
Looks, I think I'd better be on my way. John McEnroe, the rest of his journey is your problem. Gigi, out.
Oh, that was awesome. I love that episode. There you have it. Episode 7 had an identity crisis. Fantastic. One of my favorites of the season. I always love when we do a voice swap because usually it's John McEnroe. This was Gigi Hadid. And we had this last year too. We've had this before where we do the different voiceover with a different person. And I love it. I absolutely love it because it's just a different spin on things, right? Like, I love when I have one of my shows that I love so dearly, and then they do a different kind of spin. It's just fun and new. And so we get to see everything from Paxton's point of view. And I especially love that this season because it is our last season, and we very much so needed closure with what is going on with Paxton, right? Because the whole season, he's like, I shouldn't have left college. Should I have left college? Maybe I shouldn't be here, but I feel comfortable here. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know where I'm going. What the hell is happening, right? And so in this episode, we kind of find his focus of what is going on and where he feels like he is supposed to be. He keeps getting these texts from his dorm group the whole episode of all these things that are going on at the school, movie night and this and that, and he's kind of showing a little bit of regret, but it's mixed with him training Eric, of all freaking people. Eric has a dream apparently to be a swimmer on the cricket team, and so he really wants this, and he has this whole conversation with Paxton of like, why would I give up on my dream? Why would I stop trying if it's what I want to do? Right, Sam? Oh, now you come and sit next to me. I see how it is. I'm not going to give up on my dream if it's what I really, really want. And so through training Eric, he kind of learns some things himself. He not only helps Eric to the extent of him actually getting on the team, which shows what an amazing coach he is, but he learns that he needs to start taking life seriously. He needs to get his shit together, as Lindsay puts it. He's not a failure, as his mother puts it. And this is where he wants to be. And this is where he fits in. And this is right. I just love this moment that they have together, him and Davey, where they're locked in the freaking room together. They're locked in the utility closet. And they're having this heart-to-heart conversation. I love, love, love Paxton, Davey, heart-to-hearts. And they share a kiss. Now, I'm not going to lie, I did not 100% did not think that we were going to get a Paxton Davey kiss. I didn't. Because there's just so much going on with her. She's all over the place right now with different people. And so I just didn't see it happening. But I'm glad it did. Because it satisfied the Paxton Davey getting back together craving. But it also gave closure to the fact that they're in two very different places right now, and it is just not going to work at the moment. Maybe in the future, but Paxton and Davey are done. Closure. And I like how they shake on it and everything, because again, I keep emphasizing throughout this whole season, the amount of growth that has been shown through Paxton is astounding. And Davey's not there yet. Davey just turned 18. She's 17, 18. Paxton's 19. He's got a faculty job now. He's working for the school. Davey's trying to figure out where she wants to go to college. There's no way that they would be able to start a relationship now. And Davey is very much so not in on par with the amount of maturity that Paxton has been showing. Like, Paxton is a completely different person. Davey's not there. Davey's just not there. So they can be friends and they can give each other advice, which they do perfectly, but they can't be a couple. They can't be a thing. I like how at the end we have Ben go by. She makes fun of his necklace and he like puts it in his shirt, and he makes fun of her sweatshirt. She takes it off and he's like, I could see the vibes are still there, because they are. They definitely are. So I am officially calling it now. Ben and Davey endgame. I don't know if they're actually going to show that or if they're just going to allude to it, but I think it's that. I think it's that it's them. It's the end game for them. It's so fun, this whole series going back and forth, like Pax and Ben. I have never seesawed more in a show. Aside from The Summer I Turned Pretty, I feel like I kind of went back and forth a little with that. But, like, this, like, I think I've literally changed my opinion every single season. Like, season one I was Paxton, season two I was Ben, and then it was Ben, Paxton, Ben. I can't even remember. I was just all over the place. But I'm calling it, I'm setting it in stone. Took me to episode 7, but it's Ben. It's definitely 100% Ben. Ethan's out of the picture. Paxton, we had closure. It's Ben. That was such a fun episode. I absolutely loved it. Until the next reaction, so long, everyone. Try and make someone smile today. You never know when they might need it next. Bye.